friends. Thanks for joining me again today. Do you have people in your life that help take care of you? Maybe it's your mom or your dad or your grandparents, aunts and uncles, whoever you live with. They work really, really hard to take care of you and they do a lot of stuff for you. Have you ever helped take care of someone else? I've taken care of babies, whether they're other people's babies or my own babies. I take care of my children. I take care of my house and my animals. I once helped take care of my dad after he had surgery on his heart. I've even helped my husband when he isn't feeling very well. And speaking of my children, here's one of them, Jeffrey, reading our memory verse today.
Whatever work you do, do it with all your heart. Do it for the Lord and not for men.
Bye. Thanks, Jeffrey. Now, if you were here with us last week, then you'll remember that we were talking about Joseph. Joseph and his brothers all moved to Egypt. Hundreds of years passed and Joseph and his brothers ended up having many children. And their children had children, and their children had children, and their children had children. And these great, 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 great grandkids of Joseph's and his brothers were called the Israelites. There was a new Pharaoh at this time, and he saw how many Israelites there were. And this worried him because he didn't want them to become stronger than him and his Egyptians. So he came up with this plan to make the Israelites into slaves. All of this sounds really bad for the Israelites, but God had a plan. And what was cool about God's plan is even though the Egyptians were trying to stop the Israelites, instead, the number of Israelites kept growing bigger and bigger and bigger, and there were more and more and more of them. Pharaoh was so worried about the amount of Israelites that there were that he came up with this new rule to kill off all of the Israelite baby boys that were born. And he told the ladies that helped deliver the babies to make sure that this would happen. That part definitely doesn't sound like God's plan. But guess what? The ladies who were helping to deliver these babies, they didn't listen to Pharaoh. Instead, they came up with excuses for why it wasn't happening. So Pharaoh's very terrible law, thankfully, wasn't working. Now there was one specific lady who had a baby boy and his name was Moses. Can you imagine how scared she must have felt? But why am I suddenly bringing up this woman and her baby Moses? Well, it's because God chose someone special to help save the Israelites. And this someone special happened to be Moses, who was a baby. Moses's mother knew how special her baby boy was. So she risked everything and she hid him for a few months, which must have been really hard because if you've ever been around a baby, you know they're not quiet. There came a point where Moses' mother knew she couldn't hide her son anymore. So she wrapped him up in a blanket and put him inside of a basket that had tar on it so that it would float on the water. She put Moses in this basket, put the basket in the river. Now Moses had an older sister whose name was Miriam, and she was watching her mother from quite a ways away. Not long after baby Moses in the basket was put into the river, Pharaoh's daughter, who was the princess, heard the baby crying and went over and grabbed him. The princess felt sorry for baby Moses, and she decided that she was going to keep him as her own baby.
Excuse me, princess, would you like me to find a Hebrew nurse for your baby?
Yes, go.
So Miriam went to find a Hebrew mother to take care of Moses. And guess which Hebrew mother she found? Well, it was Moses' very own mother that got to care for him.
Your prayers have been answered. Moses is safe. The princess has called me to let you nurse him.
Take me to him!
Princess, I have found you a Hebrew woman to take care of your baby.
I want you to take care of this baby until he's old enough to take care of himself.
God takes care of us through others, and Miriam is really important in this story because she made sure that Moses stayed safe. She was even brave enough to offer to find help for the princess to take care of baby Moses. When Moses was a little older, his mother took him back to the princess, and the princess raised Moses as her own son in the palace. The Bible doesn't say how old Miriam was in this story, but maybe she was the same age as you are. We often think of our parents or teachers as those who keep us safe, but did you know that God can even use you to help take care of others? One way we can care for the people we love is to pray for them. So why don't we do that together? Please bow your heads and close your eyes. Well, God, we just thank you for using us to take care of other people and using other people to take care of us. We are so blessed by all the people you use to help us every day and that you even allow us to help others. Please, God, we pray for you to use us today to help somebody else. We love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, guys, are you ready for the Superfun Science Lab? Because I am. Welcome back to the Superfun Science Lab.
Super fun.
Super fun. Today, we learned about baby Moses and how his mom put him in a basket that was floating in a river. So we have a floating experiment for you today. You can try this at home if you want. You just need a container that has water in it and at least one paper clip. We have several paper clips so we can show you how to do this the right way and the wrong way. So if you just threw a paper clip into the water, it sinks. But if you use a square of a paper towel, and then put the paper clip on top of it. The paper towel is starting to sink, but as you can see, the paper clip is still floating. Why is that happening though? Well, the water molecules on the surface of the water create almost like a skin on top, and they're bound really tightly together. It looks like the paper clip is floating, but it's not floating. It's actually just being held up by these water molecules. If we disturb the water though, it'll be different. Wanna disturb the water?
I'll disturb the water.
Put that on your
finger. Disturb the water.
Let's see what happens. It made the paper clip sink. It did do something. Well, we hope you enjoyed the Super Fun Science Lab today. Join us again next week for some more fun,
sciencey things.
Bye.